we'll just go with it. Just go with it. Tell me when it, you know. Okay, welcome to welcome to Lexington for the opener of the Reading Rockets D Squad versus the Lexington Raiders. Today is Sunday. What is today? September 13th. And the captains for today's Reading Rockets, who have just taken the field, looks like number 71, Colin Donahue, and number, can't tell who that is, but the coin toss is up. Lexington has won the toss, and it looks like they have deferred. And the Rockets will receive the ball. So your captains for today are Colin number 71, Colin Donahue, and number 8, Rocco Masciarelli. We'll come back with game time action. All right, as we start game time action here, the Rockets back deep to return. Number 7, Brendan Lindmark. And it's taken up the field by number 21, Aiden Beckerhues. The Rockets will have first down. This is gonna be. All right, the Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. They're at their own 41-yard line. Rocco Masciarelli is at quarterback. Ball is snapped. And the handoff. The handoff is given to number 10, Eamon Santilla. I'm sorry, Eamon Santilla was a quarterback. It's going to be second down. Second down, 8 yards to go. The Rockets are on their own 42. Quarterback snap is two. Looks like Rocco Masciarelli, who's met immediately behind the line of scrimmage. No, I'm sorry, that was Brendan Lindmark, who's met immediately behind the line of scrimmage and knocked back. Third down and 10. Third down, 11 yards to go. Eamon Santilla at quarterback. The give is to Brendan Lindmark. He's got some room around the corner. He's met at the line of scrimmage. Loss on the play, bringing up a fourth down, and probably about 15. Fourth down, 15 yards to go for the Rockets. They're at their own 35-yard line. Brady Swanson is at center. No, I apologize, it's not Brady's. They're gonna punt. Looks like the Rockets are gonna punt. Snap. The kick is up. The kick is right to a Raider. Number 50. Jason Anderson was back there to make the stop. And they eventually wrap him up, giving the Lexington Raiders first down. All right, as the Lexington Raiders take over, it's first down. 10 yards to go. They're on the Rocket 46-yard line. It's almost like a power eye formation. The give. Good stop by the Rockets, holding them for almost no yards. Second down, 10 yards to go. Raiders still at their own, the Rocket 46. It's the handoff. He's got some room upside, off tackle. Gets about 5 yards on the gain before the Rockets bring him down. Looks like number 72, Sean Murphy, and number 23, Michael Olson on the play for the Rockets. Third down, about 6 yards to go for Lexington. They're on the Rocket 40. It's the handoff. He's up the side, up the middle. Nice stop by the Reading Rockets, bringing up a fourth down. Big fourth down here for the Reading Rockets. Try to stop on fourth and about 5 yards to go. It's the snap. It's a punt. And stopped by the Reading Rockets. Each week we're gonna profile couple of the players. This year we'd like to put the attention on number 71, Colin Donahue. Colin Donahue is a fifth grader at the Joshua Eaton School. His favorite food is cheeseburgers. His favorite superhero is J.J. Watt. And when he's not playing football, he likes to collect baseball cards and football cards. And when he's all grown up, he wants to play in the NFL. That's number 71, Colin Donahue. The Rockets now take over. First and 10. They're at their own 28-yard line. This is the snap. The handoff is to, looks like, number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis. And it's got a couple out of there. It's going to bring up second down. Looks like about 8 yards to go. Next. No, I know. All right, so we got second down, 5 yards to go for the Reading Rockets. Bringing the ball up a little bit. They're at the Lexington 32-yard line. I mean, their own 32, excuse me. Rocco Mascarelli takes the handoff. He's got the ball outside. He's motoring past a first down. He's got some room. Great run by Rocco Mascarelli and outstanding blocking by the Reading Rocket offensive line. It'll be first down, Reading Rockets. First down, 10 yards to go for the Rockets. Mascarelli under center. Power eye backfield. It's the handoff. The give is to number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis. He's going to truck forward for a nice run right there of about 9 yards. Bringing up second down for the Rockets inside Lexington territory. Rockets come up to the line. Second down, 1 yard to go. And set, the snap, the give is to, looks like number 3, Braden Nowicki. And he rushes for a nice first down. Again, outstanding blocking from the Rocket offensive line, giving them another first down. And the Reading Rocket cheerleaders have come out to support the team today. A little bit rainy, and they don't mind. Enjoying themselves, getting the fans ready for a good contest here between Lexington and the Reading Rockets. Enjoy having the cheerleaders here today. Colin Donahue will get on the ball, your center. He's in a set position. Mascarelli ready to get him to snap it to him. And he does. Mascarelli will keep it himself. He's looking for a hole off the right side tackle. And he's stopped back at the line of scrimmage. Second down. So here we go. We've got second down, 10 yards to go. The Reading Rockets are inside Lexington territory at the 35-yard line. Mascarelli's under center. The give is to, look like number 5, Quinn Dolan, for a nice rush. Off tackle, bringing up third down. All right, third down, 9 yards to go. Correction on that last run. That was Giacomo Iapica off tackle. Third down, 9 yards to go. Reading Rockets are at the Lexington 34-yard line. Mascarelli takes it, pitches it to Beckenhuis. Beckenhuis gives a nice stiff arm. He's trying to keep running. Eventually brought down, but not after about 4 or 5 yards on the game, bringing up fourth down. All right, Reading Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. Playing your guards, number 50, Jason Anderson. Number 72, Sean Murphy. Mascarelli takes it. He's going to pass it. Oh, the attempt was there. He was going for Eamon Centrella, but it fell incomplete. And Lexington will take over on downs. The Reading Rocket defense comes out on the ball playing a 5-3. It's first down. Lexington pitches it. Rockets are in there. And looks like Great play by Rocco Mascherelli. Come off the end there, off the corner, and come in and take the running back down for probably about a 3 or 4 yard loss, making it second down and about 14 for Lexington. And Centrella, second down, 14 yards to go for Lexington. They're on their own 32. There's the pitch, but the Rocket defense is swarming in there. And another great play by Rocco Mascherelli to wrap up the ball carrier after about a yard or two gain. All right, we've got third down for the Lexington Raiders. They are at their own 29-yard line. The Reading Rockets obviously looking to stop them here, bring up a nice fourth down with good field position. Lexington's up to the ball. There's the snap. It's a pitch. Sweep left. And number 21, Aiden Beckenhuis, and number 71, Colin Donahue in for the stop. It'll be fourth down. Fourth down, and it looks like Lexington's going to try to punt here. And they are. There's the kick. It's a good kick. It's taken by Aiden Beckenhuis. He's got some room on the outside. He's being pursued by Lexington. He's not going down. Oh, what a nice return by Aiden Beckenhuis, and great blocking by the Reading Rocket punt return team. So in our second player profile of this game, we're gonna look at Jack Janes. Jack Janes is number 40. He's a fifth grader over at Barrows Elementary School. His favorite food is barbecue ribs. His favorite superhero is Captain America. When he's not playing football, he loves to swim in his pool. And when he grows up, he wants to be a firefighter. That's number 40, Jack Janes. So the Reading Rockets take over on downs. They're inside of Lexington territory. It's first down, 10 yards to go. They're at the Lexington 36. The give is to, looks like number 10, Eamon Centrella. He gets a few out of it. Second down, about 7 yards to go. All right, so second down. 8 yards to go. Reading Rockets are ready to snap the ball. The snap is to number 7, Brendan Lindmark. He's got some room on the outside corner. He's trying to rush ahead. He's plowing. And I think he picked up enough, possibly for a first down, to move the chains. And we'll let the coaches make a measurement. Looks like it is. First down. Great blocking by the Reading Rockets. Nice run by Brendan Lindmark off the outside. First down and 10. First down. 10 yards to go for the Reading Rockets. They're at the Lexington 25-yard line. And there's the snap. It's to Brendan Lindmark. He's trying to find some room up the gut. And he's tackled after about a 3 yard, 4 yard game. That may be about 5 yards. Second down, Reading Rockets. All right, second down for the Rockets. They are at their own, they're at Lexington 20-yard line. And Mascherelli's going to keep the ball himself. He's got some room on the outside. Gives a nice little stiff arm to try to push the defender away. And he's able to get a nice run for a first down. And, yeah, that's enough to move the chains. So, first down, Reading. All right, Reading Rockets come up to the line. Got Brady Swanson playing left tackle, number 70, to help move the pile forward. There's the give to Aiden Beckenhuis, stopped at the line, bringing up second down. All right, 2 minutes left in the half here. The Rockets are driving. They're on the Lexington 13-yard line, maybe 12-yard line, trying to get in the end zone before the half. There's the snap. There's the pitch. It's to Beckenhuis. He's trying to get around the outside. Hopefully he can, oh boy. just not enough room. Too many black shirts in there. It's gonna bring up third down for the Reading Rockets. All set. All right. Rockets line up for third down. Number 72 playing right tackle, Sean Murphy. Gonna try to get these guys that much closer to the end zone. The ball is picked up by Mascherelli. He's trying to make something out of nothing. We got a flag on the play. Looks like we have a hold against the Rockets. That'll back them up 10 yards. Nope, they're gonna decline it and bring up fourth down. Fourth down in about 16, 17 yards to go for the Reading Rockets. They're at the Lexington 20. Mascherelli's gonna take it. He's gonna try to pass the ball. He's got some room. Oh boy. He hit him. Close one. All right, well, the Rockets, the target was Beckenhaus, and Lexington's gonna take over. First down and 10. Well inside of 2 minutes here left, maybe about a minute left in the first half. Lexington gets the ball. They're going up the gut for a couple. Bringing up second down, probably about 7 yards to go. Number six, I've called Jack. Second down, 6 yards to go. Little trap play, Lexington's trying, going off the tackle. Ooh, looks like Sean Murphy almost had him, but he's finally stopped by number 54, Dylan Burpee, on a nice stop. And looks like we've got halftime, folks. Looks like we've got halftime. So at the end of the first half, the score is a tie score at 0. Reading 0, Lexington 0. And both teams moved the ball pretty good, just not enough to get in the end zone. We'll be back second half action. My apologies on that. That was not second half. It's about 22 seconds left in the half. Lexington still moving the ball. There's a pitch. It's outside. He's got some running room. Number 8, Mascherelli trying to tackle him. Number 6, Giacomo Iapica did a nice job to stop him, at least get his hands on him there in the backfield to allow Rocco Mascherelli to wrap him up. It's going to be second down and 5 yards to go. Okay, after the timeout, the Rockets come back on the field. Second down, 5 yards to go. Lexington's going to try to pass here. Ball's in the air. Oh, boy. Little over, almost. Number 3, Braden Nowicki, got his hands on it. But it drops incomplete, bringing up third down. Third down, 5 yards to go. Lexington's going to try the pass again, but bull rushing in there. Looks like number 71, Colin Donahue, taking the entire Lexington offensive line with him to push him back. And that is going to do it. That's going to end the second half. So as I had said earlier, no change in the score. Still 0-0 as the Reading D squad enters. Well, no locker room, but enters halftime. We'll be back with second half action. All right, as we come back to second half action here, the Rockets will kick off to Lexington. Lexington drawing too deep. And second half is underway. Nice little kick. Fumbled, and it's going to be stopped down at the 36-yard line. Now, third player profile of the game, we're looking at number 33, Carter Leonard. Carter Leonard goes to Wood End Elementary School. His favorite food is pizza. His favorite superhero, he has the Human Torch from the Fantastic Four. When he's not playing football, he likes to play wiffle ball in his backyard and collect sports cards. And when he grows up, he would like to be a professional football player. So that's number 33, Carter Leonard. All right, so as Lexington steps up to the ball, we've got first down, 10 yards to go. They are on their own 36-yard line. And the give is right up the gut. trying to test that defensive line of the Reading Rockets. It's going to be second down, about 5 yards to go. On the defensive line, we have number 41, Sean Crowley. Number 42, Vedant Narayan. And let's see. The Lexington Raiders come up to the line of scrimmage. Second down, 5 yards to go. The give is up the middle. He's got some running room. He's being chased by fumble on the ball. And it's going to be Lexington retains possession of it, but nice chase. It looked like number maybe 50. Jason Anderson was on the play, though. I want to give credit where credit was due, and I believe that was him with the chase down and the strip. So nice play by number 50 and the Reading Rocket defense. However, the Lexington Raiders were able to jump on the ball, keep the ball, and now have first down. So it's going to be first down, 10 yards to go. Lexington is in the Reading Rocket territory at the 37-yard line. Come up to the line of scrimmage. And it's a give. The give is to the power eye back. He's trying to push off tackle. He's rushing through there for a few. Finally taken down by the Reading Rockets. Gang tackled. But a nice little run there by Lexington. It's going to bring up second down. All right, second down. 1 yard to go for the Lexington Raiders as they come out of the line of scrimmage. And the running back gets tripped up behind the line of scrimmage. He may have been able to jump over the first down. He did. So it's going to be first down for the Lexington Raiders. And let's see. As they huddle up, we'll look at this Reading Rocket defense. Looks like we've got number 33, Carter Leonard, playing the cornerback position. And your linebacking core consisting of Rocco Masciarelli, Eamon Centrella, who actually comes in and makes a nice stop right there behind the line of scrimmage. The running back was able to bounce out for a couple yards, but a real nice stop by Eamon Centrella. And it's going to be second down. Second down, 8 yards to go for Lexington. They're on the Reading 28-yard line. Give is up the middle, pushing the pile. And he did. He pushed it for a few before the Reading Rocket swarm defense was able to bring him down for a gain of about 4 yards on the play. All right, third down as number 80, Dylan Sweetser is in there to try to make the stop on the tackle at the tackle position, but the running back goes the other way, off tackle left side, away from Sweetser, and it's going to be enough for a Lexington Raider first down. All right, so Lexington Raiders are moving here, folks. It's first down, 10 yards to go. They're inside the Rocket 20 at the 19. The pitch is outside, and nice play by Jason Anderson. Flushes him out, tackles him behind the line of scrimmage. Loss of about maybe a yard or two on the play. Second down. Second down, 12 yards to go. Number 32, Michael Bartolini is in a tackle, and he looks like he might have made the play on that, or at least contributed to it, as Lexington's only able to pick up about maybe 3 yards on the play, bringing up third down. All right, as Lexington comes up to the line of scrimmage, third down, 9 yards to go. They're at the Rocket 18-yard line. There's the handoff. The running back's going off tackle. He's rushing through for a few. It looks like he may have gotten the first down on that. A little bit of a hole there on the Rocket's left side, and it is enough. It's enough to move the chain. So we're going to be first and goal for Lexington Raiders at the Rocket 2-yard line. Right, as the Lexington crowd gets a little fired up, let's see if the Rockets can quiet them down. Lexington drives first. on first down rather, and he gets about a yard. It looked like a quarterback sneak. The big guys up front were able to shut that down. Second down, 1 yard to go. This is the Lexington Raiders come up to the line of scrimmage. They've got a power eye formation. And they're going to try to slam it down the gut of the Rockets, but no! They were ready for it. And they stopped him. Looks like they may have stopped him for a loss. Yep, stopped him for a 1 yard loss. As we go to third down. All right, third down and one. Let's see if this goal line stand can continue for the Rockets. They go up the middle. I don't see a signal yet from the ref. No, he is stopped short. It is going to be fourth down and maybe an inch for Lexington. All right, big fourth down here as Lexington tries to get the first, to be the first on the board. And oh, he's able to get in. All right, well, good play by the Lexington Raiders as they continue to push down there and eventually put the ball in the end zone. So we've got a score now of 6-0, Lexington. All right, let's see what the Lexington Raiders here will do as they go for the extra try. They're going to run it. They go from the I formation. It's a little trap counter move. Actually, a nice little play. I like that play. And it's enough for them to get the extra point. So with 51 seconds remaining in the third period, the Lexington Raiders are 7, the Rockets 0. Okay. The Lexington will kick, but looks like we have a whistle on the play. And I'm trying to figure out what that could be. Just don't know if maybe nobody, I don't know if the refs were ready to go yet. I don't think there was a penalty on the play. No penalty on the play. I'm gonna just wait for everybody to get set. There's the whistle. All right. Try this again, let's see. Lexington back to kick. And there's the kick, and it's a good kick. And it's gonna be fielded by number 7, Brendan Lindmark. He's looking for some room outside. He's got some blocking. And he gets what he can get out of it. Nice little run there. So the Rockets bring it up to their own 41-yard line where they'll take over first and 10. First down, 10 yards to go for the Reading Rockets. They're at their own 41-yard line. Eamon Santrella back at quarterback. Nope. Well, could be. Yep, it is. It's actually given to Brendan Lindmark, who's trying to get outside. He's trying to break a couple tackles. And he's brought down for maybe about a 1 or 2 yard gain, bringing up second down. The Rockets come up to the line of scrimmage. Number 81, Zachary Galvin, playing what looks like to be the tight end position as they try to move the ball forward. And the ball is given once again to Lindmark, who's trying to make some room out of it. He's got a couple tacklers. He's brought down behind the line of scrimmage. It is going to be, it's going to be a third down. Looks like they're back to the 10-yard line, back to where they started. Third down and 10 for the Rockets. All right. Rockets come back to the line of scrimmage. Third down and a long 10 to go here. They're at their own 40-yard line, 41-yard line. Centrella and Lindmark behind. The ball is kept by Centrella. He's trying to plow ahead for a few and nothing there again. So the Reading Rockets look like they may be bringing in their punting squad here as it appears to be fourth down and about 8 yards to go for the first. Take a minute here to acknowledge the coaches for the Reading Rockets. The head coach of your Reading Rocket D squad is Dave Swanson, assisted by John Mascherelli, assisted by Rich Donahue, and assisted by Ron Iapica. Those are your four coaches will be guiding your Reading Rocket D squad this season. So the Rockets come out. It's the beginning of the fourth quarter here. They're in punt formation. They've got about 4th and 9, so they want to boot this thing down there and hopefully push Lexington back. Let's see, it looks like Muscarelli's back there to take the kick, and his knee was down. No, that's not Muscarelli. That is Giacomo Iapica, but unfortunately, the refs are going to rule the ball down because his knee hit the ground when he caught the ball. So an unfortunate break there for the Rockets, as the defense will have to step up here and really, you know, try to get that ball back. So 1st and 10 for Lexington. First down, 10 yards to go for the Lexington Raiders. They're at the Rocket 35-yard line. Rockets defense is shifting a little bit. The give is up the middle. He's got a little bit of room before, looked like number 8, Rocco Muscarelli, grabbed him by the legs, and number 23, Michael Olson, took him up top for a nice tandem tackle there. So, check that. That was, I believe, Carter Leonard who made the tackle up top. So, nice set of tackling there by the Rockets. Lexington does get a couple yards out of it. It's going to be 2nd down, about 6 yards to go. There's the give, and he's able to plow ahead for a few. So we've got 3rd down coming up for Lexington. 3rd down, 5 yards to go. There's some movement on the line. There's a flag. It's against the Rockets. Offsides. I believe that's going to be enough for a 1st down, and it is enough for a 1st down for Lexington. As they were a little anxious. I like the integrity. I like it, but you gotta wait till the ball snaps. So 1st down. For the Reading Rockets, first down for the Lexington Raiders. They're at the Reading Rockets 25-yard line. They come up to the line of scrimmage. Power eye backfield. And the ball's on the ground, but it's stomped on by Lexington player. They're going to retain possession. 2nd down. 2nd down. 11 yards to go. Lexington gives the ball. Oh, he's got some room. And he's able to make a few yards out of that carry. It's going to be not enough for a 1st down. But it was a nice little run on the play, bringing up 3rd down for Lexington. With 4 yards until the 1st down, Lexington is at the Rockets 19. There's the give. He's going outside. He's trying to find some room on the corner. And he's got some room on the corner. It's being chased, but not in time for the Reading Rockets to bring him down. He trumps into the end zone for a 6 yard, 6 points. And Lexington will try for the extra attempt. As Lexington lines up, try for the extra attempt. They will go with the run or pass. And quarterback looks like he's going to try to keep it himself, but he's being chased on the corner by Eamon Santrella, who gets his hands on him, and enough to let a couple other defenders, Rocket defenders, get in there and stop it. So they were able to stop the try. So with 7 minutes left in the fourth quarter, or in the game, the Reading Rockets trail the Lexington Raiders 13-0. The Lexington Raiders will kick off. Back deep is number 3, Carter Lerner. Number 7, Brendan Lindmark. And the kick is up, and it's going to be taken by number 8, Rocco Muscarelli, who's going to try to get outside. And he plows ahead for a few. Nice gain. We're going to get 1st down, 10 yards to go. The Rockets are on their own 42-yard line. So we're going to need a nice little drive here by the Rockets, as they are, like I had mentioned, down by 13. 1st down and 10, number 54, Dylan Burpee checks into the game. Ready to help out that offensive line, give those backs some room. The snap given to Muscarelli, who's gonna hand it off to Beckenhaus, but is met behind the line of scrimmage for probably about a 1 yard loss on the play, bringing up second down. Number 22, Jordan Whitmer, comes off as he came in there to help out the Reading Rockets offense. And we've got second down, 10 yards to go. The give is to Musciarelli, who is immediately met behind the line, as the Rockets are unfortunately going the wrong way. We've got a third down coming up from their own 44-yard line. Big third down here, third and 14 yards to go. They're set. The give is to Musciarelli, who's going to try to throw it, but he is he's sacked. He's sacked behind the line of scrimmage. Unfortunately, as soon as he got the snap, there really wasn't much he could do as the black shirts were swarming around him. And it's bringing up fourth down. Let's see if they decide to go for it here. I would imagine they would. Yep, looks like they're gonna keep the ball and try to scamper all the way down. They've gotta get to the Lexington 44-yard line in order to get a first down. They're at their own 39-yard line. So fourth down and about 16 on the play. There's going to be the snap. The give is to Beckenhaus. It's a sweep to Beckenhaus. He's got some room on the outside. He's enough to bring it back almost to the original line of scrimmage before he's pushed out of bounds, giving the Lexington Raiders the ball. Turnover on downs. Lexington's going to take the ball. First down and 10. All right, first down, 10 yards to go. Lexington is at the Rocket 45-yard line. They've got the ball. It's a give to the running back. He's trying to make some room outside. And looks like number 80, Dylan Sweetser, was in on the tackle. And it's going to be second down. Second down. And the ball is given to the running back. He's pushed outside. Gets a few. And we're going to have, it's going to be bringing up third down. Third down and about four for the Lexington Raiders. All right, Lexington comes up with the ball. Third down. They give to the quarterback. He's trying to get outside. He's finally brought down by number 10, Eamon Santrella. There is a flag on the play, which is going to be a holding against Lexington, backing them up 10 yards. So that'll put the ball back to about the Rocket 46-yard line, making it third down and about 13 or so. All right, third down, 15 yards to go, 16 yards to go.
Let's go, Rockets!
Lexington still inside of Rocket territory at the 48-yard line. About 2 minutes left in the game. The pitch outside to the Lexington player. He's met at the line of scrimmage. He's still going by number 80, Giacomo Iapica, who does a nice job of getting back up off the ground to make the tackle for the second time. Finally bring him down. He was also assisted by number 23, Michael Olson, on the play. And that's going to bring up fourth down for the Lexington Raiders, who I believe will probably try to punt. Yeah, they're going to punt the ball. And it's going to be fourth down and about 16 to go, as Lexington will punt. Back deep for the Reading Rockets is number 21, Aiden Beckenhaus. And the kick is on the ground. He's going to attempt to kick. So, but he's trying to make some room, and he's finally brought down by number 80. Dylan Sweetser on the play to push him out of bounds, giving the Rockets the ball midfield with 52 seconds left in the game. So the Rockets will take over first and 10.
All right, first down, 10 yards to go for the Reading Rockets. Let's see if they can punch one in here before the game is over. The ball is snapped. It's given to Muscarelli, who's going to look like he was going to try to throw it and then tucked it under and decided to run with it. And he's stopped behind the line of scrimmage. Looks like about a one-yard loss on the play. Second down as the clock continues to run. Yep, clock is running. We're about inside of 30 seconds left in the game. Reading ready to snap the ball. It is, once again. Ramacharel is going to try to pass it again. And he's got Beckenhuis for a nice play. Beckenhuis is rushing up, but he's finally pushed out of bounds. They were able to get the first down and then get out of bounds. Probably about 8 or 9 yards in the air by Muscarelli, and then another 6 or 7 yards, maybe 8 yard rush run by Beckenhuis. Meanwhile, the Reading Rockets blockers were out there in front to get him that first down. So we've got first down, 10 yards to go, 9 seconds left in the game. Actually, we've got a timeout on the field. So first down, 10 yards to go. First down, 10 yards to go. This might be the last play of the game. Let's see. Rockets. Muscarelli under center. He's going to try to air that out. And he gets it over to Centrella in the nice flat pass, who gets it, but he's brought down as time runs out on the field. I do believe, yes, it is. That's the end of the game. So the Reading Rockets open up in Lexington, but unfortunately lose the match here as the final score is 13-0 by the 13-0 for the Reading Raiders. Excuse me, Lexington Raiders. The Reading Rockets did do a great job in their opening game here. Very good blocking up front by the line. Excellent tackling, I thought. And you know, they'll be a good team this year. So it's Hold on. Looks like we've got one last play here on the play. A little confusion there. One last play, and it's okay. I believe. Okay, you running? All right, so that is the end of the game, folks. The end of the game, 13-0 Lexington. As we mentioned, the Rocket D squad here, a good squad, played well. Just fell a little short here on a rainy, misty Sunday morning in Lexington. So that is it from Crum Field in Lexington, and we'll see you next week.